So here we are, YouTubers again. This is, of course, you recognize the library on the back of the Paramount Theater right now. Lee Park is right there. Oh, this is 3rd Street. Of course, it's all closed off. Nobody can get through here either with a vehicle. I can hear musicians down on the mall right now. People are sitting in outdoor cafes. Kinds of little bags and things. That's what my Jalea bags is all about. It's like cell phone bags, travel bags. There's a store over here called The Second Yard. And they carry curtain fabric and upholstery fabric, which is really wonderful fabric for making bags. Here's the entranceway to a business. I always admired this apartment building across the way. People put out the most beautiful flowers on their balconies. Another alleyway. Here we are, 4th Street. So I'm going to walk down and show you the businesses here. This is a wonderful used bookstore called Daedalus. Sometimes I wonder how the building can take all the weight of all those books in there. All the wood floors and everything. Then there is a pie store. Homemade pies. I've had lots of their homemade pies. They're really good. There's that grocery store that I walked by the other day. Back of the closed road sign.
Like, this train is clearly happening.
Flower store.
Like, why are we all waiting for it? How long do
you try, like, to park or something?
Sure.
Or chair.
Yeah, something outdoors.
Or, like, let me think. How's the lawn? Is that okay?
Oh, there's a lingerie store over there. Used to be a comic book store. I think, or maybe this other one was the comic book store, the one that's closed now. I think they might have had oriental rugs or something in there. Now here's the oriental rugs over here. It seems like they had something to do with that kind of thing. And there's a smoke shop. Oriental rugs.
I like that area. I avoided it.
Tiny alleyway, mostly for garbage and stuff. Another alleyway. This is a big tall building. It's right behind the Impeccable Pig. And I came here to turn in my cable wireless to the Blue Ridge Internet Works when I left City Walk downtown. I think it's like 8 stories tall. It's one of the newest buildings. So we're coming down to the downtown mall, and the Impeccable Pig is on the corner down here. I'm trying to think where that restaurant might be. It was in that that one video that guy made, where he was talking about a friend of his that was working here had. She was there when all these dangerous people got off the buses and ran in there and wreaked havoc. Kind of expensive. I bought a few things in there over the years. So anyway, it's kind of sunny down here right now. But, see the big bump in the road? So that car. The shoe fell off the car right over here. That's one of the things I'm totally amazed at. How did that shoe hang onto the bumper until it came all the way back here? He's driving so fast and then it just sort of fell off right here in the center, right by this manhole cover. That was pretty bizarre.
Oh, stop.
This is a great pharmacy over here. Timberlake. It has a little sandwich counter in the back. They've got old time things in there. Stuff that you don't normally see in drugstores anymore. There's the Impeccable Pig. That's how tall that building is right there. Right over there too. about race jewelers? Well, it's been here a very long time. Doesn't have anything to do with blacks and whites. It's a family name. Of course, people love to make big deals out of stuff that they don't know anything about. So this thing over here, the Urban Outfitters, this is really, used to be a hardware store. But then they changed it into a restaurant that they called the Hardware Store. And it had a lot of really neat old wood and booths and things. And we have this New Year's Eve thing, festival, where they have all kinds of like free things. And buy a ticket and you go into all these different places where they have music and poetry reading and stuff like that. So then the hardware store went out of business. It became an Urban Outfitter. Oh, and there's some guy who goes around town and he does these things. I've got a bunch of pictures of this. He draws these cats. Sometimes they have a real sort of oriental look about them. Somebody posted them out. Maybe that's the guy who does them. I love the way he draws his lips.